Hey, welcome to Zach's Tech Turf and weekly download episode number 52, which is my weekly tech and PC gaming news series. Today, I'm gonna be playing some Modern Warfare Remastered. I got my coffee over there, but most importantly, we're doing a $20 Steam gift card giveaway to celebrate 1 year of weekly download. I did the gift card so I could do this giveaway worldwide and not just in the United States. So I just wanted to say thank you so much for the support over the last year. Head on over to my Twitter. I'll have it linked down in the description at Zach's Tech Turf. All you have to do is retweet my pinned tweet, super easy, and I'll announce the winners in next week's episode. But for now, let's get into it. To start off the PC gaming news this week, EA has announced that Battlefield 1, Titanfall 2, The Sims 4, and Star Wars Battlefront expansions are all on their way to Origin Access. I've said multiple times now that Origin Access is a very legit service, and it lets you play a huge library of games, only getting better and better by the way, for just $5 a month or $30 for a year. We don't have exact dates of these baller games coming to Access, all we know is that it'll be towards the end of the summer. Next up, Ark Survival Evolve developers have upped the price of their soon-to-be fully released game to $60. This has some people extremely upset, DayZ developer Dean Hall specifically, and you know what? I kind of agree with them. Ark Survival Evolve is my number one most played game on Steam, and it's added a crap ton of content over the last year, but it really does have a bunch of bugs and certainly optimization issues that still need worked out. The fact that this game has been listed at $30 the entire time made us all kind of accept Ark for what it is, so for them to literally double the price when the game is still in desperate need of tweaking is kind of bizarre. Once again, this is all my opinion, and Dean Hall's. Some more Steam UI update details have been announced, and it seems that Valve is putting a heavy emphasis on curators' recommendations this update. During their slideshow, they explain that they are completely reworking how Steam recommends games to us gamers, and they will be utilizing curator lists much more than they do now. There's also a ton of UI tweaks that they plan on making, and I'll have the full 42-minute video down in the description if you guys want to see more on that. Another Netflix-like PC gaming streaming service is about to launch, and it's called Jump. Jump will be hosting a $10 a month streaming service specifically for indie games only. This is apparently a great way for indie developers to get their name out there and have people actually see their title. Right now, Steam is completely overflooded with indie titles, so I guess this should work, you know, until the service gets flooded as well. I'm not a big indie gaming guy, like at all actually, but I'm interested to see the quality of the service, so I might subscribe for a month or two and give it a review. Make sure you guys let me know if you'd be interested in that. And to wrap up the PC gaming news this week, Tony Hawk Pro Skater HD is being delisted from Steam on July 17th, and it's on a heavy discount until then if you want to grab it while you can. This last version of the Tony Hawk Pro Skater series originally released on PC in 2012, and you can pick it up for just $2. I remember playing the earlier games on way older systems and absolutely completely wasting my life on it. I would sit down and do the same scenario, level, or whatever it was over and over again just trying to beat my friends' high scores, and it was a ton of fun. I don't think this PC version had so much popularity or anything, but I figured I would let you guys know. Alright, to start off the tech news this week, Oculus Rift prices have been slashed for the summer down to $400. For $400, you are getting the VR headset as well as their touch controllers, and is this what we've all been waiting for? I believe the VR headset initially started at like $700 or $800 or something crazy like that, and that's purely the reason why VR hasn't taken off yet. At $400, this is quickly becoming very tempting. Now yeah, $400 is still the price of a new console, for example, and you still need a baller computer to run VR, so I think we are close to VR becoming a thing, but still not quite. Next up, we found out this week that Intel is definitely not getting rid of their current Pentium G4560 processor. The G4560 is a very, very budget-friendly option that most PC builders are aware of, as it provides a ridiculous price-to-performance ratio on gaming. I've actually recommended this in some of my builds, such as my $350 build that I recently did, but the price of the processor since that video has consistently been seen around the internet for about $20 more. Some places are even now selling it for over $100, and a theory was produced about it being because Intel is discontinuing the chip. Intel confirmed that this is just a normal swing in demand, and they will continue to produce their Pentium. Good news there. If you have a 4K Samsung TV, you can now download the new Steam Beta app, which allows you to stream your Steam library from your gaming PC directly to your TV, just like the Steam Link works, which I reviewed by the way. The app is still in beta, so I would definitely expect some bugs, and it currently only supports 1080p resolution at 60 FPS, with 4K support coming soon. The app also only works with a Steam controller or a wired Xbox 360 controller, but support for other controllers are coming as well. This is actually pretty cool, as I personally don't think enough people are utilizing the concept of a Steam Link. I'm absolutely in love with playing my full Steam library down in the living room by only using a tiny device the size of a portable hard drive, but now you can do it directly from your TV, even better. Moving on, the company Red, which you might know from their baller 8K cameras that all the top tech YouTubers use, announced that they are making a smartphone for the first time, and it's actually already on sale. Their new camera starts at over $1,200, and apparently it's featuring a 3D holographic display. Their goal is for you to see actual depth when looking at your phone, not just a 2D display. Top tech YouTuber MKBHD just released an entire video explaining this, so I highly recommend you go check out his video if you want to see more on that. Let him know I sent you though. I need him to check out ZTT IMO. And finally, to wrap up the tech news, Asus just put a very ambidextrous friendly mouse on the market called the Puggio. Maybe Puggio. Most gaming mice are clearly designed for right-handed gamers, while lefties are usually just an afterthought and they have very few sound options. Asus decided it was time to change that, and the Puggio looks like a great option. It features a 7200 DPI sensor, Omron switches, and most importantly, the ability to add or remove the side buttons. This allows you to place covers on the opposite side of the mouse, so you lefties out there aren't accidentally clicking buttons all the time. I personally wouldn't know if this actually happens that often or not, but hey, I'm glad they're trying to appease everyone here. Well, that wraps up Weekly Download episode number 52. I just wanted to thank you guys so much again for the support over the last 52 episodes of Weekly Download. Let's get another 52 more. Don't forget to head on over to my Twitter at ZaxTechTurf for a chance to win this $20 Steam gift card. Well, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please drop a like down below to help support my channel, and as always, thank you for watching, and please subscribe for more Zach's Tech Turf videos.